Welcome to my bookshelf, the little treasures that give me big pleasures, if you know what I'm talking about. It's Easter, so what a better book to read than Killing Jesus. Yes, Killing Jesus, by Bill O'Reilly and Martin Dugard. You know that biblical story of the arrest and crucifixion of Jesus? Yes, Jesus is arrested, taken to Pilate. Pilate tries him and finds absolutely no fault in the guy. Now this book, the writers believe that that whole story is either fictitious or lacks in context. It is difficult to believe that a man accused of blasphemy, according to Matthew, Mark, and John, and also accused of telling people not to pay taxes, according to the book of Luke, can be found not guilty by a colonial administrator governing Judea on behalf of Caesar. This book paints a picture that either Pilate passes for one of the most lenient judges in the world, or there was democracy veiled in the autocratic nature of Roman Empire, which is difficult to believe. The Roman Empire was a very ruthless regime. That is a fact. They suppressed anybody who brought a different opinion, who came up with different opinion, was suppressed in a very ruthless manner. So therefore, it is difficult to believe that a man accused of the biggest crimes that you can ever have, opposing the rule of Caesar, can be found not guilty by Pontius Pilate. The book of Luke even cunningly brings in Herod into all this mix. I mean, Herod is a local, he's a Middle Eastern, like Jesus. Brings in Herod into all this mix of the trial of Jesus, which these guys here find a bit out of shape, a bit out of context in the entire saga of the crucifixion of Jesus. It's a book I would really recommend to you, especially this time of Easter. Go out, read something different. Look for something different to read. It's Easter. Hey, happy Easter. That's my bookshelf.